Well, I'll fade to gray soon.
You're so beautiful.
On the TV station.
Thanks.
Yo, what is up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I post every Monday at 9 a.m. MST. And today's topic, I got a lot of good feedback on that last video of the Living Alone Diaries. So I think we're just gonna keep writing those out for the next few weeks. And each Living Alone Diaries, I'm gonna cover three different topics. And today's topics, first one is we're gonna do an unboxing. I gotta ship out some packages as well. And also I wanna do a walkthrough workout. And if you guys want to see anything from me in the future, be sure to put it down in the comments. I read every comment and I will get back to you guys, and I appreciate your guys' feedback. Also, I wanted to mention one more thing before we get after today. We only have a few more of these left in stock of our fitted tees, and we have whites available, but you can use code Anthony and you can get 10% off. So go check that out. But we're going to get this day started. Let's get after it.
I won't lie to you guys. Running business has been fun. I really enjoy it. Easily one of the most challenging things I've ever done, but the sky's the limit with running a business. That's the best thing about it. And the biggest goal for me by the end of the year is to hire a full team for ICE, which I totally think is doable. And we'll be reaching out to a lot of people, putting out a thing for applications by the end of the year. But it's definitely hard. You just got to be willing to fail over and over. Learn from it, stay uncomfortable, most of all grow. But when it comes to starting a business, especially the people that have done it, when you ask for help, there's no one to help you. No one wants to help you because everyone that started a business had to learn for themselves. And we learned that pretty quickly when we were reaching out to people and no one wanted to help. But we've learned so much because of it. It's kind of a blessing that we didn't find people to just push our business, because we could start multiple businesses in the future because we know so much about it. But it is challenging. So I just got a care package from ASRV. Just want to give a quick shout out to them. I appreciate you guys for hooking me up with your most recent drop. If you guys haven't checked out their fall collection, go check it out. It goes so hard. I'm super stoked to see what I got. And when it comes to sponsorships, I'm not sponsored by ASRV. We have something in the works. But I don't really go out of my way and look for sponsorships just because I have my own brand. But ASRV is an exception just because I rep their shit so often. Oh, wow. How you like this, Connie?
That feels hard.
This thing's tough, dude.
Hard.
This thing's tough.
I'm gonna have to take that for a spinny.
Yeah, honestly, the thing with me, because I don't buy my clothes, I honestly just get clothes. So I always give them away eventually. Because I'm always getting clothes sent to me. So I don't know how long I'll have this stuff, but it'll eventually end up in my homie's hands. I actually got some homies some stuff in here, but we gotta rep it. Got some sweats. I got Taylor some sweats too. Got some tees. Dude, there's one thing in here though that I'm super stoked on. It's this vest.
I've seen that.
Did you see that vest?
Yeah.
Dude, it goes so hard. Got some more sweats. Honestly, I have so many shorts from ASRV, and I don't have any sweats. Like, I think I have one pair of sweats, and then I have a lot of hoodies from them, from their past drops. But, you know, I've definitely wanted to get some pants and stuff. This is another hoodie. I just got a blacked out hoodie. And then, dude, this is what I was stoked on. I saw Aaron repping this, their model, and I was just like, yeah. Well, I'm gonna be real with you. Your boy don't go out, so. this is gonna be an indoor casual fit, but it's about to get real cold outside.
We're going on an adventure.
Yeah, you literally look like you're going somewhere.
Next stop, Columbia.
Her ears are so cute.
So flappy.
You got it.
Are you taking my girls? I'm getting jealous. No wonder. You need to get jealous. I think I'm getting jealous.
You love me, huh?
Yo, quick shout out to Una. I appreciate you. If you guys don't know who she is, go check her out on Instagram. She's literally insane with the jump rope, and she said she was sick of seeing me with a wire. So I'm super stoked to use this. She actually sent me like a whole tutorial of her sizing her jump rope just to show me. And it means a lot. In this message, she actually mentioned 75 hard and how I inspired her to do it. And that's what it's all about. In the end, I'm posting this content for you guys. And the more I do it, the more I realize I get more satisfaction out of the impact that comes with it. I like to inspire and motivate you guys a lot, and that's one of the things that keeps me going. I always look back at messages when I'm having a hard time, and it keeps me moving forward in my life. So I appreciate you, Muna. The message means a lot to me, and I'm stoked to use this. I'm stoked for you as well, because big things are coming your way, but I appreciate you.
You're gonna get a walk-through workout from the guy. I'm him, it's me. And a lot of you guys ask about my kicks. These are Nike React Visions. And honestly, they're my favorite shoes right now. And when it comes to shoes, I usually only rep one pair of shoes in the gym, sometimes two. And I just wear them till I run through them. And I've had a lot of Nike Reacts, but these ones have definitely held up the longest. But when it comes to like any functional stuff, these are my go-to kicks.
Let's get this.
We're gonna do 125 jumps, and it's gonna be a different variation throughout the jumps, but if you can't do these, just stick with the standard jump rope. And what we're gonna do first, we're just gonna do a standard jump for 25, then we're gonna do the high knees, 25, and then we're gonna jump to single leg. I try to stay on my toes for 25, alternate the leg, 25, then we'll finish off with double unders. And from there, what we're going to do, we're gonna do two different ab variations, one on the ground and then one hanging. And I'm gonna walk you through those after we get this first set done. Let's get it. All right, after the 125 jumps, what we're gonna do, we're gonna go straight to the ground. We lay on our back. We're gonna keep this knee up and same knee, same arm. You're gonna put this behind your head, put the other arm on the ground. And if you can't get up while doing this, you're just gonna use your elbow to push you up, but you're gonna extend this leg and elevate it, and you're gonna drive that knee to this elbow. You're gonna go for 10 reps, and if 10 reps is too much, just cut it down a tiny bit. Find what's comfortable for you, and after the 10 reps, we'll alternate, extend and elevate, bring it up, and really try to focus on fully extending so you can get that stretch through your entire core. After the first ab variation, we're gonna jump on the bar. And like I said, I like moving at my own pace. I try to do everything and then take my resting period, which is 2 to 3 minutes. But if you gotta take a break in between, you're perfectly fine. Just try to stay a little bit uncomfortable. That's how you progress. We're gonna jump up. And once we're up, we're gonna drive our knees around, like in a around the world formation, back down. Then we're gonna come back the same exact way. And we're going to try to contract as much as possible throughout it. So you really want to twist. And we're going to do that for 10 reps. Take our resting period, then go into the next set.
Yeah, I'm stoked.
Our homies are doing real good over in the lab, you know what I'm saying?
All right, let's do the second set. Last set, guys. Let's run it. Thank you. Right there?
Yeah.
Nice, one more.